He is a man called to preach good news to the poor, heal the brokenhearted, proclaim liberty to those who are both in physical and spiritual prison, and declaring that the time of the Lord's favor has come. Join him every Sunday and experience divine visitation, total healing, and real deliverance through the power of prayer and the spoken word.
I've seen believers that have been born again for 20 years, they don't have a child.
For the Lord shall deliver thee from every evil work.
I've chosen to release you from this wicked chain of injustice.
And your life will never be the same again.
There's a champion inside you. There's something special inside you. You have ability to prosper.
Failure is not your portion. You will never fail in life.
The author of several books, including Freedom from Evil Foundation, Destroying Destiny Destroyers, Silencing the Voice of Evil Sacrifices, Eliminating Satanic Obstructions, and much more. Join him in one of our services for counseling, prayer, and personal ministration right here on this station.
Call or visit www.domlive.org.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallah, my dear viewer, this is the Hour of Deliverance. My name is Pastor Jones Adeboati from Deliverance Outreach Ministry. My prayer is that God will touch you, God will bless you, God will lift you to different level. Situation will change. The grace of God will be abundant on you. In this month of beauty, in this month of shining, in this month of light, God will visit you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Father, we thank you today. Let your word be quick. Let your word be powerful. Amen. Bring deliverance to your people.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. I'm very, very happy. I'm here with such an important personalities here with me. Daddy, and I call them Daddy and Mami Ahito. My sister is here and the husband. And we're going to talk about so many things. And we're going to share testimony. We're going to talk about how they get to the land of Israel. We're going to talk to them how they met their ministry, how they see our ministry, and since they met our ministry, what God is doing in their life, and how God connect them to this great land, this land of the altars. And if you want to come with us to Israel, by this testimony, God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And for your information, there is a telephone number on your screen over there. Start calling that number. Let me pray for you. And send me your text message. I have my mobile phone somewhere, and I can get, and then we're going to continue to read it and to pray for you in Jesus' name. Daddy and Mami Ahito, may God bless you. I'm very happy. Anytime I see you here, there's something about you that makes smile to come on people's face. Amen. And may God bless you for the thing that you are doing. Amen. Please, I want you to capture everything we are talking. Go and find a pen and a paper and sit down. All the information, get it, because it will bless you. Many people are going through a lot. Daddy Ahito, before we went to the question, before we go through the question time and before you talk, I want us to read this quotation quickly. Mm-hmm. Before I ask, in the book of Lamentation, mm-hmm, chapter 4, if you read verse 1 and 2, he said, how is the gold become dim? Mm-hmm. How is the most fine gold change? The stones of the sanctuary are poured out on the top of every street. Look at verse 2. The precious sons of Zion, comparable to fine gold, how are they esteemed like this? And excuse me, Van Wedu, that is what your family was going through.
Absolutely.
God gave you a great wife, a good wife, but every day, sickness, things were not going right, everything. And many people are watching, and I know by the testimonies and by encouragement and by how God has lifted you into this level. That's why I'm saying, how is the most fine gold change? A woman with intelligence that has written her own book, how she was attacked until deliverance came. And now if you see this woman helping all over. When we're going to Israel in May, pastors came from Kenya, yeah, pastors came from US, pastors came from Canada, pastors came from Holland, from London, all over the world. Now, fulfilling her mandate. See, A lot of people are hearing strange voices. Mm-hmm. A lot of people, your wife said something to me the other day. She said, between madness and sound mind is a thin line. I never forget that thing your wife said. Why was she saying that? Because maybe she nearly stepped into the other side.
Yes.
It took great husband and great ministry to bring her back. Yes. See, I'm talking to you. Maybe you are going through certain things that are beyond your control. Mm. You are hearing voices. You are going through terrible nightmares, dreams. You are seeing demonic bears, demonic animals following you. You are seeing invisible presence around you. Your life is going through backwardness, non-achievements. Things that are not supposed to happen to you is happening to you. But there is a destiny for you. There is something God wants you to fulfill. And that's why many people are being frustrated. I see great men. I've seen great women. That's supposed to be a groundbreaking in science and technology. Mm. But they are wasting away, pining away in mental home. Mm. I've seen great women that's supposed to be modest, but they have married, no children. I've seen great sons that have been stabbed and killed. It's not their fault because something is wrong from their background. I'm very happy for you to stop everything that you are doing to come here. Before we talk, can you introduce yourself? As Daddy and Mami Ahito is talking, could you call that number? I want to pray for you. Maybe you are going through certain things. You are going through a lot. Call that number. Send me your prayer request, and I'm going to pray for you. Daddy, please introduce yourself and your wife, and then we're going to talk.
Well, thank you so much, Apostle of Deliverance.
Yes, sir.
That's why we call you. We know you by that name.
Yes, sir.
It's a pleasure to have this opportunity to be on stage with you. My name is Anthony Aheto. You can see it on the screen. People call me Tony, but you've decided to call me Daddy. Daddy Aheto.
Daddy Aheto, yes, sir.
Well, I accept everything, all his name to me. Mm. The journey is long, but we will try and make it concise. We came into this deliverance ministry, I would say not by chance, but I believe that it's a divine connection.
Mm.
There's no coincidence
In
the spiritual world.
Mm.
Yeah, everything that's in every stage of your life, whatever you come across, it's part of God's agenda.
Mm.
You know, he's shaping you. It's just because we can't discern the voice of God. We don't know when he's directing us.
Mm.
But in every situation, he's actually ordering your steps to lead you to the right place.
Mm.
And we are very grateful to God for actually helping us through the situations of life that we've gone through.
Mm.
And I just thank God for what he's doing and what he's even yet prepared to do through human vessels.
Mm.
And we just want to honor God and then honor where honor is due. When we came into Deliverance Outreach, we came for help. Little do we know that there is a bigger agenda that God has prepared for all of us.
Hallelujah.
And it amazes us that in a very short period, what God is doing, it's only time will tell because we believe that there is still more ahead of us.
Yes, sir.
We just want to encourage everybody that deliverance is a key instrument of our life.
It's real.
The Bible says that if you break a covenant, the sins of your fathers will be visited to you, the third and fourth generation.
Yes, sir.
Covenant is something that God holds dearly to his heart.
Yes, sir.
And we all know that from the background in which we are coming from, covenant has been violated.
Yes, sir.
And no wonder God in history decides to pick up a vessel, and that vessel is one of that vessel is you, who is projecting the covenant that has been broken by our forefathers. That there's the need for us to actually get back in line. Mm. If you are driving a car and the car is off alignment, mm. you realize that you would either, you would, number one, wear your tire, mm-hmm. and the car will be going one direction. Mm-hmm. I suffered it just recently. Mm. My brand new car, mm. I wasn't paying attention to the alignment of mm-hmm. my car mm-hmm. because of the numerous bumps on the road. Mm-hmm. And my car went on, yesterday I went and spent £350 to change my two tires and the alignment. Why? No. Because I'm off gear. And that is what is happening to a lot of us. So I would, we would continue and then we would let the viewers know why the need for deliverance and why we have the need to be connected
to this
with this land, the land of Israel.
I'll come to you again. I'm coming to your wife now. Mama Hitu.
Yes, sir.
God that connects you, we spoke so many times about how God connects you to this great man here. Mm. And by God knows that the ministry you are going to do needs somebody with a lot of patience, with a lot of understanding, mm. to understand you, to understand the land of Israel, to understand the word of God. And you were going to marry somebody, and a prophet said, no, this is your man. That's and right. then suddenly everything that you are God gave to you now is coming to pass.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And when a man is in destiny, that they are hito, the person is happy.
Absolutely.
Many people are watching now. They are going through what you are going through. Could you share your testimony before I'm going to ask you again how God connects you to this land? What you were going through before you sat on the TV, you watched the TV, spoke to your husband, and you came to see us.
Thank you very much, Apostle mm. Boateng. It's always a pleasure to be with you mm-hmm. and an honor. Yes, as my husband Anthony has already said, mm. we were going through several challenges. Mm. Challenges in my health. Mm. Because I just don't want to fast forward, but yeah. I know we're going to get there.
Yeah.
But as soon as I embraced mm. this mandate mm-hmm. of repairing the breach, mm. all hell broke loose. Mm. And I was experiencing weird circumstances. Sometimes in my sleep, I'll have hands try to strangle me, for real.
In the dream, this is real. You can even feel it.
I feel the hands, but I don't see the hands.
Yeah. So invisible hands.
Invisible
hands. Choking you.
Choking me. I mean, I would scream, and I think across the road, 10 houses down, I'm sure they will hear me at 2 a.m. I mean, and he was lying right next to me. And if it wasn't that, it was hearing footsteps mm-hmm. enter my room. Hey. I mean, I was hearing it. He wasn't hearing it. Mm-hmm. I was hearing it.
Yeah, yeah. That's spiritual. You remember Paul said, I heard the voice. The people around me didn't hear the voice.
Yes.
The light that slid me down.
Yes.
So when the visible presence are coming, yes. it comes to attack the one that they have their name.
Absolutely.
Others around does not.
No.
Yes. So I was experiencing different challenges prior to that. But when I embraced the mandate, then all hell broke loose. Mm. So, I mean, I would have this nightmare experience.
Excuse me. When you embrace the appointment God has given to you concerning yes. this land, the yes. land of Israel,
yes.
we're going to talk about it.
Yes.
That's when the attack
all appeared. Hell broke loose.
Mm. Okay.
I mean, pressed down, shaking together. I would be sleeping and it was like something was pressing me down. Mm. I would try to scream. I've heard you share something like yeah. that before. I had that several times.
It's very terrible.
You'll be screaming, he'll be lying next to me, and he wouldn't hear.
No. You think you are touching someone, no, yeah. nobody.
Till you manage to get the name Jesus out.
Ah, yeah, kata.
And then you'll be free. But it happened too many times. Mm. And then I'll wake up with all sorts of blotches on my body. Mm. I mean, sometimes I'll go to bed quite late, maybe after midnight.
When you wake up, you will see visible
blotches.
Marks.
Yes. Blood, in places blood. I couldn't show a third person, mm. but just him. Mm. You know. And these were visible blood blotches all over my body. Mm. Then a few weeks after, I would have these unexplainable symptoms. Mm. So if it was my head, it would seem as if there was a hammer.
Serious migraine.
Serious. Mm. I mean, I would have to go from GP to hospital to consultant.
Pain tablets.
Mm-hmm. I mean, pain tablets, yes, the everything. I mean, the cocodamols and everything. You know, and then I would have to go as far as the consultant who would...
That means it was very serious.
Yes, sir. Yes. Who would now tell me there's nothing wrong with me? And I knew there was something wrong. Mm. I mean, mysterious. If it was my belly, I'll have to go through all the checks, go into all the machines and out. And there was nothing wrong with me. Mm. But there was something eating me up. Mm. I was losing weight at one point. I mean, to cut a long story short, at one point, I lost appetite for a whole year. Yeah. Mm. And it was like something had locked in my throat. Mm. So I couldn't eat. Mm. So I would just force myself to have a banana.
And all these things, you were that time born again.
I was born again.
Still
sir.
Born again.
I was born again.
Worshipping Jesus.
Yes.
Going to church.
Loving the Lord.
Pay your tithe.
Yes.
Do everything.
I did everything.
But the spirit that come to your room to choke you, the angel of the Lord are there, God is there, Jesus is there, they couldn't prevent them.
That is why what you are teaching is so relevant, is for our time. Because it is real. Spiritual warfare is real.
Listen to me. As mommy is talking, maybe you are watching me. I'm not going to cut her short. I came here to ask certain questions from them, and we are going to talk about what they are doing. They are doing fantastic job. Very, very fantastic job. They have their own ministry, the repairer of the bridge ministry. Their telephone numbers are there. If you want to go to Israel, or you want somebody to help you, to help your ministry, to give you the quote, or how did you say it? Direction to go to Israel to do the Sukkot, what's the name?
The Feast of Tabernacle.
The Feast of Tabernacle, how to prepare the food of the Shabbat food.
I think Passover.
Last time you went and teach somebody how to do all those things. They will come and help your ministry. Their telephone numbers, I'm going to put it on the screen and do it. But the thing this wonderful man is talking, it's something that is dear to me. Maybe you also, you are going through the same thing. Pressed down in the sleep. You are going through attack from north, south, east, and west. There's a destiny in you, but whatever you touch died. You feel that something is wrong with your body. You go to the doctors. They have given all their medication. It's not working. Something is behind it. Call that number quickly. I want to pray for you. Send me your text message quickly. I want to pray for you. You hear me? Mm. Mommy, I'll come to you again.
Yes, sir.
Daddy. The testimony your wife is sharing, you were lying beside her. You couldn't hear anything. When she wake up and you see all these marks and all the things that she showed to you, how do you feel, and how do you feel for her?
Yeah. You know, before we started, you said that she said something to you that between madness and sanity, it's a thin line.
Yes, sir.
You see, when those things are happening, and you are not part of it, you think somebody is
exaggerating.
Is exaggerating. Christians have taken the subject or the word of God out of context.
Mm.
When Bible says that if any man be in Christ, is a new creature, behold, all things are gone away.
Mm.
Absolutely right.
Mm-hmm.
But.
Mm. The word but.
You have to, act and determine how to actually get into being that new creature that Christ has given you.
I like that. You have to.
Yes.
Or you have to take the word of God and implement it and enter into your new image.
Your new image. It is a fact. If it is not the fact that we are new creatures. The Bible haven't said it. But Jesus says something. Since the time of John the Baptist.
Up to now. The kingdom of God suffers violence.
And you have to be what?
Only violent man can take it by
force.
Yes, sir.
I've just spoken about covenant. Covenant is one of the sacred elements of our Christian walk.
Yes, sir.
If you understand covenant, that you have now entered into a covenant relationship with God, you would move into a dimension whereby you will understand that because you are in covenant relationship with God and you are obeying the covenant regulations and commandments, God is obligated to be with you and fulfill his part.
Yes, sir.
Because he never fails. He cannot change.
He's a covenant-keeping God.
But the fact remains that Bible says that if the foundation be destroyed,
what can the righteous do?
Amen.
The foundation on which we are built on as being Christ in us, the hope of glory, has been destroyed by our forefathers.
Has been tampered with.
It's been tampered.
That's why I read it. How
are the gold?
Gold change.
Change.
The precious sons of Zion.
That's it.
Why are you like this?
Yes. The same lamentation says, our fathers have sinned.
And they are no more.
And no more.
That's chapter 5, verse 7.
Yes. And the children, what?
Are suffering.
Are suffering.
Eating sour grapes.
Until you understand that you have to actually deal with the violation of covenant which has been established by your ancestors and your forefathers, you can hit your head to the wall. Nothing. Hear you will this. Not be living the victorious Christian life that God has given us.
I'm coming. Hear this. Hear this. It's very, very important. The thing this wonderful man has said is very, very important. That's why I cut him off, and I want to talk to you 1 minute. Maybe you also, you come from wrong foundation. Maybe your fathers, your mothers worship certain idols. Maybe you also, you wake up, you see marks over your body. You see things over your body. You are going through a lot that only you and you alone knows it. Please, there's help around.
Yes.
Don't sit down and die. Call this number quickly. Call it 0207-923-2549. Send me only text message on the mobile phone, and I'm going to pray for you. Call it, let us agree. One word from God will change your life.
Amen.
You hear me? Daddy, before I go to mommy again, how did this thing, there are so many men that has married to women, or there are so many women that has married to men that are going through this spiritual battle. Now, how can they get help? Or how was your patience towards all this thing your wife was going through?
Well, first of all, you have to really understand that it is only the person that the aunt is in his clothes or her clothes that is feeling the pinch.
Yes, sir.
You have to actually... The fact that you are not experiencing it doesn't mean
it's not there.
It's not there. Mm. You have to establish that. Mm. Then secondly, you have to, if you are married, that's why I keep going back to covenant. Mm. If you are with somebody who is your wife, your husband, you have to know that you are in covenant, a marriage covenant with that person. Mm. And you made some covenant vows that you're going to be, for better, for worse, you're going to actually spend the rest of your life with that person. You have to love unconditionally. So when that person is going through this sort of unexplained difficulties that you don't really actually understand, you have to seek help. You have to stand by that person and work it out and seek help.
I like the word seek help. How about you two?
Yes, sir.
Your husband has said certain things which is very powerful. You have to seek help.
That's right.
You have to seek help. And that is how you were going through all those things. I cut you somewhere.
Yes.
Could you take it like 3 minutes to us and share how all this thing happened and the thing that you saw, the best that you saw, and then you came to the ministry, and then we come into this one.
Yes. So like I said, after we received the mandate, what I spoke about previously, these unexplainable attacks at night. In addition to that, I had some sort of knife-like sharp pains.
Things where it's like it's
like darts in my back continuously. So I had to be carrying with me painkillers every day, taking them like every 4 hours. Because they were very sharp. They could happen any time of the day. And so for example, I was sitting down here with you and just
you
all
feel
of a
something
sudden,
attacking.
Sharp, yes.
And when it happened like that, you must take pain tablets.
Pain tablets, because I couldn't move. It's very difficult. So it happened so often.
You haven't told me this one.
I know, I'm coming to the best. So I'm progressively coming to, you know. So when it happens, I'll just have to take these painkillers every 4 hours.
So it's like 24 hours on the clock. You just monitor for 4 hours the pain tablets.
To the point that I became used to it.
Addicted to it.
Yes. Because I would all of a sudden be hit anytime. I would wake up in the morning and I'll be fine.
Yeah.
Then about 12 in the afternoon.
Or you feel choop.
All of a sudden. And this pain will be there for days. You know, that was another issue. And so these things were going on. But prior to that, somebody had introduced me to your first, I think one of your first books, which was Ancestral Patterns. Very small book, but very powerful. And I was very interested. So I looked at the back and I think there were some addresses of where you were before.
71 Ronald's Road.
So I came there
and
we bought some of the books. I think I bought about 4 books then. And I could never get enough, you know, because your books are so insightful. They're so insightful. I mean, they're like painkillers. So as I began to read, I began to get relief. But the relief wasn't permanent. But I had some fair amount of relief. Mm. So I would come every night, every time you wrote a book, mm-hmm. if you ask maybe Mr. George or Sister Temi,
yeah.
they would tell you that I used to come there in the afternoons yeah. to just buy your new books.
Yeah.
And I was just engaging in the books. Mm. And the pains also continued. Mm. Till one day I saw you on telly. Mm. And you were preaching and you were saying, don't sit down there and die. Mm. You know, don't sit down there and die. It was so direct.
I thought
you were talking to me. Mm. It was so direct. Mm. But I think I've forgotten something. Before then, as I was reading these books, there was a time there were 9 birds mm-hmm. that visited our home. Mm. In the midst of all
this
the
is
weird
not physical birds.
Physical yeah. birds. Mm-hmm. Weird looking black birds. Mm. In fact, since then I've never seen such birds horrible again. Looking birds in, mm-hmm. in this country. And they came into the garden, they formed a circle, mm-hmm. which I thought was very weird.
Mm. And you so were watching?
We were watching. In fact, it was my daughter who came to tell me that the birds had formed a circle mm. and there were 9 of them, mm. dirty looking black. So I thought it was weird, but you know, I hadn't seen it before, so I thought it was just one of those things that mm-hmm. go away. Mm-hmm. They didn't go away for a long time. Mm-hmm. Then all of a sudden, I realized 8 had gone mm-hmm. and left one.
Remaining one day.
The one spent the whole night there. In the mm-hmm. morning, it was still there. Mm. Then it started walking towards our door, mm-hmm. which is like 50 meters away, mm-hmm. and started hitting the door with his beak.
Oh, yeah. Cock, cock, cock.
You know, knocking. In fact, it was so weird. I thought, what in the world is this? So I went to the door and I stood there. I had read enough from the books. I had got enough insight.
So confidence has appeared.
Yes. So I stood there and I said, this bird is very weird. In the name of Jesus, I curse you to die. And Apostle, you won't believe, the bird could not fly away.
Fly again. Die instantly. By the word.
By the word.
Hey, Baka. That's what your husband is saying. Stay with the word.
And amazingly, I started to get better. It was then I decided no.
When the bird died, you started getting better.
Getting better.
Hey, okay, continue. That's very powerful.
I started getting better.
Hear this. Hear this. Maybe you are listening to me. That is your story. Not that was your story, because Mama Hito, what Mommy is saying, that was her story. And because it was her story, now she can share it to others. Maybe that is your story now. You are feeling pains in your body. Things are moving in your body. I did a prophetic something in our church about a week ago about a mantle. A lady took one in my presence. She tied it on her head.
Yeah.
And migraine for 3 years disappear.
Yeah.
Things that are moving in her body, in the head, yeah. disappear. Yeah. She says when she seated there, she want to hit her head. When that thing come, it's so strange. Maybe you are watching me. You are going through the same thing.
Yes.
Things are moving in your body. How can 9 weird birds mm-hmm. come in your garden, sit there for about 1 hour or 2 hours, and when they leave, the other one studied the whole day, and the other one marched all the way into your door, and a glass door, and yes. knocked the door. I've been in your house.
Yes.
I saw it. It's a very beautiful glass door. Mm-hmm. And knocked the door.
Mm-hmm.
And when you speak in the name of Jesus, die, the bird died.
The bird couldn't go away. He even went to bury the bird.
Yeah. And the moment the bird died, you are well. You were well.
I started feeling well.
Yeah.
I started feeling well. And you know, one thing I didn't say is that, you know, people should not take this for granted, because yeah. after I read the books, mm-hmm. I didn't see the need of coming to the church
yeah.
to seek further help.
Yeah.
Because I thought I was reading the books and I was fine. Mm-hmm. So I just read the books and that was it.
Mm-hmm.
Till I saw you on telly again.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time I saw you, I was going through all sort of mm-hmm. Challenges. So mm-hmm. I thought, no, I would come.
Mm-hmm.
So I came.
Mm-hmm.
And what you were teaching that day, mm-hmm. I realized was totally different from what is in the books.
Yes, sir.
I would come home and watch you on telly,
and
there again,
different.
Another, you know,
yeah.
different mm-hmm. Focus yeah. of deliverance.
Because
and I thought, wow.
The TV one is like evangelism.
Yeah.
To bring them to the church mm. so that I can teach them to be empowered.
Yeah.
To have confidence in themselves.
Yeah.
To tell them that you are bigger and better than the enemy out there.
Absolutely.
You can defeat that enemy.
Absolutely.
That's how I do things.
Yeah.
Here was different. Here is different. The book is different.
Yeah. But they were all progressively helping.
Yes, sir.
And giving me, and imparting to me the spirit of boldness.
Mm.
I was not bold like this mm. before. Mm. I mean, I knew, I loved the word. Mm-hmm. I knew how to pray.
Mm-hmm.
But the type of prayers that mm-hmm. we engage in the deliverance outreach mm-hmm. is what we need for this end time.
Thank you, sir.
Because the demonic activity in the world, we don't need to be a prophet to see
yeah. yes,
how bad it has become.
Mm-hmm.
So we need this type of different mm-hmm. techniques in prayer.
Now, thank you very much. Dada Hito.
Absolutely.
Your wife, Thank God, God has healed her. Today she's very, very strong. I never see a woman strong like that. In Israel, when I see her putting her small bag and wearing her small trousers and walking on the mountain of Zion, you know that God has healed her.
Yeah.
How she's bouncing, massaging you every day, I know that God has healed her very well. Now, how did you come in contact with this? This is, I call it deliverance mandate.
Yeah.
Because to take people to Mount Zion, Bible says, upon Mount Zion, there shall be holiness, there shall be deliverance, and my people will possess their possession.
Yeah.
I remember one of the first visions God showed it to me in 1990 is, I'm delivering from your family, and I'm going to give you a ministry to show my people there's inheritance for them.
Yeah.
And the quotation God gave to me is part of this thing.
Yeah.
So, how did you get this thing, and how did you bring this thing to pass?
Well, actually, that would have been a subject for her to answer, but I will start.
And no, I'm going to go to
yeah,
her.
She will chip in.
Mm-hmm.
We, in 2005, 2006, we used to be part of a ministry, and then eventually we had to part company.
Mm.
And we had our own, she's a caterer by profession.
Mm.
And we had our own cafe, state of the art on the Leytonstone High Road.
Mm.
One of the first. I mean, we invested a lot of money into it just to bring it to that, because she likes cooking, fusion cooking. She calls it, and it was doing very well in the beginning, and then within about a year, there was another cafe that was opened by somebody up the road.
Mm-hmm.
And all of a sudden, we realized that things started going down the drain.
Part of the attack.
it's amazing. You see, the testimony that we have, if you want to share it, it needs three, four, five programs, you see.
Mm-hmm.
But to just keep it short, first of all, we are people, we are a couple that loved God.
Mm.
We've been called into service industry, ministry.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever we go, we try to just serve, because we believe that is the area of call on our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what we've been doing in all the ministries that we've been involved in. So we are students of the word.
Mm.
If anybody is listening to us today and believe that there's no room for deliverance, I beg to differ.
Repeat that.
I beg to differ on it. I beg to differ. That is true, that there is certainly a room for deliverance.
Hey.
There are 101 churches all over that have congregations.
I bet to differ.
The members are suffering. They are believers. They've been born again. All right. But they are suffering.
They are suffering.
Some of them, they can't find, the young, beautiful girls cannot find children.
Hold on 1 minute. Look at the camera behind me. What should those people do? People that are suffering, going through evil dreams, nightmares, pain, rejection, abuse, what should they do?
When my wife was going through this unexplained attacks, I said, you have to seek help. You cannot sit down there and suffer in silence. So we begin to seek help. We spend money to go to private hospitals.
Yes, sir.
Trying to employ the best doctors. They couldn't find anything, because they think it's a spiritual attack.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
But the doctors today don't know.
It's true.
They will just go do all their tests,
to
their knowledge. So what you need to do is to seek help.
Seek help.
If medical science, look, thank God for medical science, but there is a point they cannot go further.
Yes, sir,
you
it's
know,
true.
The spiritual is first before the natural. So we should not discount the fact that there are forces at play over here.
Forces are there.
We have the spiritual forces that are fighting against what God has done.
I like that. Yeah. The spiritual force fighting against what God has done.
Yes.
Hear me. You are watching me now. There is something, there's a mandate, there's a vision for you. You're a minister. But there's forces out there stopping you.
Yeah.
I used to say this in my church every time that in every man's promised land, there are giants. There are giants. And giants are there to hinder you, to stop you. before I go to Daddy Mommy, we have about 10 minutes. How many minutes do you have now? Okay. And Mommy, your husband said this one day you have to come in. After the deliverance, you came there, we pray by the teachings, your confidence was built. You can now stand on your feet, all those things. I saw your book, beautiful book. You have written a book about
repairing the breach.
Repairing the breach, contribution to the God end time agenda.
Yes, sir.
And I saw this beautiful thing over there. Now, what do you mean by repairing of the breach?
Repairing the breach is a ministry committed to the end time agenda of God.
Regarding, what do you mean by the end time agenda?
You know, the Bible says that gospel left Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and went to the ends of the earth.
The outermost part of the earth.
But the thing that many of us don't understand is that God is faithful to his covenant, his everlasting covenant, which he made with his people.
Yes, please.
And Paul gave us a little insight about it, that when the Gentiles have received the gospel, God would give his people a second chance.
Yes, please. Yeah.
Which he's now doing.
Yeah.
So they did not just, God did not just, you know, forsake them, like Paul says.
Entirely.
But after he has engrafted us all in, like he says, and we have all become partakers of the root and the fatness, he would reach out to his people once again. And I didn't know anything about this till we went on a family holiday to Israel. Preceded that, we had been watching Roots and Reflections.
Barry Siegel's
Roots and Reflections. At the time, there was nothing much about Israel. So I had been watching him and a few other American ministers whose focus is on Israel. And I've been watching their program. But Roots and Reflection, I loved. I mean, when he came on, I would stop everything and sit down. I don't know what just attracted me to that program. Unknown to me, but today we know now that it was God.
The calling.
Yes. So I would watch him watch all the repeats and never have enough of it. So after that, we were planning a family holiday and we decided, I mean, let's go to Israel. I mean, at the time, they had just finished the Lebanese war, whatever they were doing over there. It was quite a difficult time, but it was so strong that we felt we had to go. And we felt that we didn't have to go with it all. We had to go as on a family, just explore. So we rented a place. I'm just summarizing here. We rented a place in the south, in Jerusalem, and then also another place in the north. Unknown to us, God had something more in store. So after he had waited patiently for us to explore.
So who was the driver? Daddy was the driver.
He was. No, the first time we used public transport.
Oh, okay.
The first time we used public transport to, you know, go around. We actually engaged a tour guide to show us around. So after God had patiently waited for us to finish all our touring, we were invited to a congregation somewhere in the north. And over there, I saw for the first time believers just like us. And I was surprised because I thought there was nothing like that over there. You know, I thought they were all, you know, Orthodox Jews and all that. I didn't know they were believers. I was quite surprised. And within 3 hours of us being there, there was this wonderful lady there who had been there from the beginning of the, you know, when God started actually calling them together at somewhere in 1974. She went there. So it was her house the congregation met, because most of them meet in houses. So she began to talk to us and share with us. And I didn't even understand why she was sharing all those things. But within 3 hours, she gave us quite a download. Good background of the development of the Messianic believers in Israel. And we spent some time there. We picked up a few things. Then we came back to Jerusalem to spend a few more days to come. In fact, the first time we spent 3 weeks there. And whilst we were there, we went to Bethany. And as we were coming back, there was this another believer standing on the Mount of Olives. And he also captured us and began to share with us.
It's all God agenda.
Yes.
The birth of the ministry called Repairer of the Bridge.
Yes, sir.
Now, Daddy, let me come to you because we have just 7 minutes to go. Now, when this ministry was born and you started going to the land of Israel, how do you feel, number one? Why do you encourage people to go to that land?
Yes, like my wife said, it's an end time agenda of God, because God has a plan for humanity. Since the time Adam fell, he has set up a program of his, we call it the redemptive program or plan of God.
Yeah, the redemptive plans of
plan of God. Mm-hmm. And he decided to pick up a person called Abraham and to use him to show humanity how he wants to be worshipped, how he wants us to approach him.
Yeah.
And then hence the Jewish race came to be born. Mm-hmm. Now, the word of God is ambiguous about the plan of God. Mm-hmm. If you read Romans chapter 11, it is completely stated clearly in plain language.
Because somebody is watching now and the person is confused. Why must I go? Why must I spend my money? I remember my friend Apostle Bismarck was talking to me about somebody in his church saying that the money you pay $3,000 to go and spend 10 days in Israel, I could have used it to buy plot or whatever. So what can you say to encourage somebody? Why must we go as a believer to go to this
land? It is very eminent for every believer to be encouraged to go to make at least once in a lifetime trip to where the genesis of your faith. Every faith, anybody who practices any faith, they do their very best to visit where it began.
Sir. Where the altar
people
is.
People who are in the Baha'i faith, they try to go there. They try to go to India to find out where the roots is. You know, that's their outside that place. You know, the Muslim brothers, they try to go to Mecca once, at least once in their lifetime. It is a part of human, listen, the word that you are reading, when you go there, it becomes life to you. You see that it is not just somebody who is just concordant. You see the events, the things that you read in the word of God.
You are their life.
It becomes life to you. You need to be encouraged.
So what do you tell somebody out there? What encouragement would you encourage somebody out there?
In fact, I vehemently encourage every believer, if you are a child of God, where your maker, your master walked, you need to go and find out that place. I mean, you are born in a town. You would have to go and find out where your fathers, your parents came from.
Your ancestry.
Now we've been born into the family of God, right? You have to actually go there to see where it happened. Is it really true that there was a Nazareth, a village called Nazareth? Is it really true that there was a place in Galilee whereby he walked under this
thing? There's a Jordan there?
Yes, there's a Jordan River where he got baptized. You go to these places and you will see it becomes life to you. And I'm telling you that you have to get connected.
Hallelujah.
You see, prophetic action in the word of God is very important.
You wait, we'll come there. Mama Hito, according to the thing that the producer is telling me, we have just 5 minutes to go. When we are enjoying it, the time goes so quick.
Yes.
So, you've been there several times. Before you came there, God heal you, give you strength, give a man back to his wife. Every time I see my in-law, he's smiling. You said your massage is extra. Yeah. Now, connecting the ministry, repairing of the bridge, into deliverance ministry. And since we went there with you, the prophetic action, we've been going from places to place to place. Last time you were saying something to me that you've been there, you saw many, many great ministries that has gone there. But what we go there and we do, not you alone, because in case said the same thing, Pastor Gladys said the same thing, Pastor Nyamsu said the same thing, Apostle Bishop said he has lived in
Israel.
In Israel for 3 years. In fact, he had never experienced such prayer before. Could you show it to somebody why they must connect to this prophetic action and why is it necessary?
Now, going to Israel with Apostle Jones is another extraordinary experience. Because not only are you, it's like a triple blessing. Because you go, you explore the land, you go to the historical sites, but you're also able to pray on location. And the focus of Deliverance Outreach is the altar. And that is the supreme altar.
Yes, sir.
Israel holds physically the blood of God.
It's true.
It is the blood basin.
It's true.
It is physical. This is not spiritual.
It is the blood basin.
It is the blood basin. That is where the blood of God dropped.
Habakkuk.
You see, so the connection of repairing the breach and deliverance outreach is very plain.
In conjunction, going there, stand on Zion, read the quotation of Zion.
Pray prophetically. If you have Goliaths in your life, praying in the Ela Valley, you slay your Goliath. If you go to the Mount Carmel, if you have Ahab in your life, the prophets of Baal, you deal with them. It's another dimension altogether.
Jordan and understand
it's
what
another
is the
dimension.
Jordan.
Being baptized in the Jordan. I mean, we have been baptized in the Jordan and dedicated several times. But going with you, I mean, we just came back from there. A few weeks ago, it was a blessing to go back in there because there is a progressive revelation.
Yes, sir. Yes,
you
sir.
Know, you get to get the revelatory truths from the Word of God to empower you in this end time in your spiritual warfare.
Truth. Yeah. Revelatory.
You see,
truth.
Yeah. And he says something which I want to add briefly before we go.
Yes, sir.
Derek Prince says something. Mm. We owe the Jewish people. Mm. This ministry is birthed out of appreciation.
Yes.
Appreciation. We appreciate what God did for the redemptive work. We cannot take it for granted.
Now, before we go, I know our time is up. Before we do, let me leave my glasses so I can see your face very well. I want to connect to this great ministry. We are going back to Israel again in October. And we are going again in next year, May, for prophetic action. Like Mami said, we stand on Mount Zion, we pray. We stand on Mount. We don't care who. Mount Carmel, we pray. It's not Mount Tabor, we pray 2 hours. We pray inside the Jordan for about 2 hours. Now, there is a telephone number that is there. This is the email, repairerofthebridge.org. That's the email,
sir.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Please, get the email. If you want to go with us, we have the form here. We'll send you. This is the form they should fill, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the booking forms. You fill this form, it's quite far. You can't see it very well. But the moment you email or this their number, you call it to them. They will give you everything. They will give you where we'll be going to October, line by line, by line, by line, by line, subject to change, because
we spend time
to pray it, and we don't joke at all.
And to bless the land
and
of Israel.
And to bless the land of Israel as well. Next week, when we are coming, we bring some clips to show you when we were there with the rabbi in charge of the Wailing Wall.
We
connect to him, sow seed to him, and it was a blessing. Please, you can go to their website. I think their website number is there. The repairerofthebridge.org. All the necessary information you are looking for, you're going to see it. And it's a blessing. Yesterday night, I went through it. I went to all your website over there. I've encouraged them to put their pictures there so that you can see them. Hallelujah. And put the pictures of the land of Israel over there. It's a blessing for our ministry to connect to them. To them, I used to say this, and that you think that maybe it is because of your wife was not well why you came. But you didn't know that you have an assignment for our ministry.
Absolutely.
Because my prayer is to connect myself to them.
Yes.
Today, I for your information, we are going October 18th. Is the Sukkot.
We join in Barry and Batia.
Barry and Batia. Mm-hmm. And by the grace of God that you connect us, today I have the privilege to stand over there to preach in the Sukkot.
Yes.
I'm among the preachers.
Yes, sir.
If you go there, I every time when I'm there, I just click it and see my name over there.
Yeah.
How can this villager name comes over there?
Yes.
Because God brought you, connect us to the Lamb of God. And when I stand there with all the Jewish people looking at me, and when I preach, they came and hugged me. It's such an amazing standing there doing the one I enjoy is the Jerusalem March.
Yes.
Over 100,000 people.
It's a rehearsal. That's the Feast of Tabernacles.
Yes.
It's a rehearsal, you know. So that is what is going to happen when Jesus comes back. The second
walking
time.
Walking all over.
Yes.
Now listen here. This week, I want to give you this book free of charge. Hear me. I want to add two of my book. This is a prayer book. Mami Ahito is saying, all the prayer I pray in my church, I put all the prayer here. From A to Z, the deliverance prayer in the name of Jesus, I pray and I destroy the throne of iniquity, house of witchcraft, altars, receive fire, any cauldron. From number one to number zero is prayer. All the prayer I pray in my church. And this is the one that we are talking, the altar versus altars. And this is deeper knowledge of altars and witchcraft. And I want to add this book to you. The Repairer of the Bridge, yeah, that Mommy and Daddy has written. Mm. I read through it about 3 times. Mm. You can use just 20 minutes. You can sit on your toilet. Mm. By the time you finish, you finish reading it. and it's something that is very, very powerful. Mm-hmm. From Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, the 12 tribes, the prophets and kings, the family of Israel, the Virgin Mary, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Apostle Paul. How you receive this information and put all this thing here, mm-hmm, everything here, mm-hmm, please, I need to give you this book. Mm-hmm. If you can sow a seed of £20 or more, mm-hmm, to help our TV ministry, mm-hmm, I'm going to give you these 4 books. Mm-hmm. If you make a check, make it payable to Deliverance Outreach Ministry and request that you watch me, and I want to give you this book, Repairing of the Bridge, Contribution to God and Time. Agenda. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Please. And every seed that you sow, we keep this seed and we send it to the land of Israel.
Yes. Mm.
Send it to go and help the rabbis.
Yes. Mm. Repairing
God,
the breach.
Repairing, yeah. And God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We have 5 minutes to go, Daddy Ahito. Yeah. Please, our address is Unit 1, 17 Algal Avenue, London, E10, 7QE. Every Tuesdays, every Wednesdays, every Fridays, I do one-to-one counseling. Like Mommy and Daddy said, to me, I can't remember the day you came to the church. I've been saying it. But all I know is that you are there. Yeah. And I'm very happy that you and your good husband, you are there.
Yes.
Please, maybe you are going through a lot. Maybe you also you need deliverance. Maybe the same thing she's going through, you are going through it. I'm going to bring you here next week. We are here again.
No problem.
Because it's very powerful. And I want you to call the number. Come there. Come and see me one-to-one. I have time with you.
Yes.
When I tell people I have time, I'm going to see them. The lady came last week. She was so shaking. Mm. She was so shocked. When sister started coming, called me, Daddy, somebody wants to see you. Mm. I said, bring her. And they brought her to my office. Normally, I don't see people in my office. Mm. We have a prayer room.
Mm.
But the prayer room was occupied. So I sat the lady in my office. She was so shocked. She was literally shaking. Pastor, am I here? I said, yes, you are here. She said she's been in her church for 9 months, never seen a pastor before.
Mm.
We are not like that.
It's
Daddy Ahito, before we go, what do you tell people in a nutshell, like 2 minutes? What encouragement concerning what you were living, sleeping, staying with your wife 24 hours, and what your wife was going through? And you brought your wife into our ministry, God heal your wife. What advice can you give to somebody?
Yes, the advice is just about, I just reiterated again that, look, when you are, it is you that is feeling the pinch in you.
Mm-hmm.
When you are having issues and problems, you know that, look, first of all, you have to examine the patterns that is happening in your life and begin to actually address it.
Mm.
Seek help.
Mm.
Do not sit down there and suffer in silence.
Mm.
Seek help, get advice, and find out how you can actually be liberated from what you are going through.
Yeah.
And I must tell and must encourage people that there is a spiritual aspect to everything.
He said now, look at the TV here.
Mm-hmm.
They want to, because the advice you are giving is very powerful. So look at me and then.
Yes.
Hey.
Yeah. So what I'm trying to say is that make sure that you seek help, you know, because it is such important thing. It is you that is going through the problem.
Mm.
Go find help for yourself. Nobody would do it for you. And there are people that God has called out. People must understand that there is the spiritual and there's the physical. So if the physical is not helping, which is i.e. the medical science is not helping you through what you are going through, please, God has set people over us, you know. There are men and women that God has called to bring solution to us.
Liberty.
You know, God hurts when his people are going through pain, especially as a child of God. There is solution for you.
Yes.
And the solution is found
in ministry. It's like medical side.
Yeah.
We have the dentist. We have the chiropody
for the nail.
Mm. We have the brain surgeon.
Yes.
We have the bone.
Yeah.
We have the gynecologist that look to the womb.
Yeah.
We have all those things.
Yes.
So it's very important. Mommy, in a nutshell, what do you say somebody? What do you tell somebody?
Mm.
The thing you were going through and how now I see you are healthy.
Mm.
Your children are very blessed. Last week I was with you and your husband and how your children were crying because how far God has brought you. What advice could you give somebody?
Like you said to me, don't sit down there and die.
Mm.
There is help.
There's help.
There's spiritual help.
There's help.
And even the Bible says that where the Spirit of God, I think it's Isaiah 61, he said that the Spirit of God came to bring us liberty.
Yes, sir.
So there is liberty for us. And God has set people in places as he said. So don't sit down there. Come and seek help. And not only seek the help, engage in the spiritual instructions. When you engage in it, I guarantee you, your life will turn around. You will receive the liberty. You will receive the freedom in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Hear me. I'm very, very happy to get them here. They are very, very busy people. Like the husband said, the wife is a cook everywhere. And the man is a very, very busy businessman. And he don't joke with his time. But thank God that they have come here to share. But I'm going to talk to them. We're going to come again and do it again here tomorrow to you, and then I know for sure your situation will change, your life will change. So tomorrow, don't mark it that myself and these wonderful people will be here tomorrow to share another blessing to you. For your information, we are going on this so-called 18th of October 2016, and then we are coming to on 25th. Please, all their information is on your screen now. Repairer of the Bridge, the telephone numbers are there. Write it down. That's why I tell you to take the telephone number. Write their telephone number. Write everything and be part of this powerful trip, and your life will never be the same again. Please, if you want to come with us, do it quick, because we have secured the number of the flight, and we, if we must secure more, then we can get more. May God bless you. May God anoint you. May God lift you on high. May whatever you do prosper. All the people that have sent their text messages, emails, I pray over them in Jesus' name that God will heal you. Oh, keep calling. My number is 0795070185. May God bless you. May God empower you. May God lift you on high. May God bless your children. May God heal your body totally in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Myself and Daddy Ahito and Mama Ahito said, God bless you. Whatever you are doing, you are protected in Jesus' name. Go to our website. We have radio in our website. Go and listen to the word and change your life. Amen. Bye-bye you. Bye-bye. Hallelujah.
He is a man called to preach good news to the poor, heal the brokenhearted, proclaim liberty to those who are both in physical and spiritual prison, and declaring that the time of the Lord's favor has come. Join him every Sunday and experience divine visitation, total healing, and real deliverance through the power of prayer and the spoken word.
I've seen believers that have been born again for 20 years, they don't have a child.
For the Lord shall deliver thee from every evil work.
I've chosen to release you from this wicked chain of injustice.
Your life will never be the same again.
There's a champion inside you. There's something special inside you. You have ability to prosper.
Failure is not your passion. You will never fail in life.
The author of several books, including Freedom from Evil Foundation, Destroying Destiny Destroyers, Silencing the Voice of Evil Sacrifices, Eliminating Satanic Obstructions, and much more. Join him in one of our services for counseling, prayer, and personal ministration right here on this station. Call or visit www.domlive.org.